back to the class. Okay, see, till yesterday we have studied new kings and kingdoms lesson. Okay, that we have studied about new dynasties, okay, prahasties, land grants, okay, and about Nagbata, okay, and we have read about administrations in the kingdoms, okay, warfare for wealth, and we read about Muhammad Ghazni, okay, and Chauhans and Cholas, okay, right, and the Cholas sculptures, okay, and temples, okay, whatever they have given, how much they have given importance to the temples, and agriculture, okay, how they developed agriculture, and irrigation methods, which type of irrigation methods they have used, and administrations, okay, how they have format the administrations, okay, that all we have learned in this lesson. Yes or no? And even we have learned about the types of land. Okay, Chola's inscription mentioned several categories of land. Several categories of land. What are those? Vellang Vagi, land of non-Brahmin properties. Brahmadeya, land gifted to Brahmins. Okay, Brahmadeya. Land donated to Jaina institutions. Okay, which land is donated to the Jaina institutions? They were called as Pilichandam. Okay, how they were called? Pilichandam. Here types are called. Which is donated to the Brahmana? Brahmadeya. Which is donated for the schools? Shalabhoga. And which is donated, gifted to the temples? Devadana. And which is donated to the Jaina institutions? Pilichandam. And which is land for non-Brahmins? Vellang Vagi. Okay, see, at the Chola times, for the land names they have given that type of titles. Okay, and here, okay, till yesterday we have discussed about this. Okay, each Brahmadeya was looked after by an assembly or sabha, okay, prominent Brahmana holders. These assemblies worked very efficiently. Their decisions were recorded in detailed inscription. Yes, these we have discussed yesterday. Okay, see, land kings were giving the gifts to the Brahmins in the form of lands. So therefore the Brahmins has to be attending to the sabhas if it is any need of administrative side. Okay, administrative side, maybe in the solving of any case, okay, or else giving a knowledge about any particular thing, okay, that type of issues have solved by these Brahmanas. Excuse me. Okay, see, and here they gave one inscription, as I told yesterday. Inscription means nothing but a written something on somewhere. Okay, a written something. See, in previously, in the olden days, means when the kings were ruled, you know, at that times, inscriptions were written on some of plates, okay, on iron plates, or also some palm leaves plates, or else stone inscriptions upon the stones. or else that stone inscriptions are there, they kept as a wall for the temples, like that. Okay, here that type of inscription they gave, inscription from Uttar Meruru in Chingalpet district. Okay, these all names, it's all old names. Okay, and Tamil Nadu. Okay, Tamil Nadu area. Okay, and provide details of the way in which the Sabha was organized. Here one inscription is there, that means one information is there about the Chola times, the place of Tamil Nadu places. Okay, how the Sabha was organized. Okay, how the Sabha was organized, that information is there. See how the Sabha is organized, you know. Each and every kingdoms, okay, in the king's sabha, they have some of the people have their own duties. Okay, each one have separate duties. For example, one will collect revenues from the people, the other will see the problems and justice, that type of kind. Other person should see any other maintenance and all, like that. Various departments works are there, and some another person should look at farmers, irrigations, developments, like that. Like this, each and every works have separate. And in that sabha, king is allotting for each and every person have separate departments. See, for example, now in our democratic government also, our ministers have their own departments. Yes or no? See, irrigation minister, home minister should look after protection side. Okay, and another one is minister for villages. Okay, another one minister for finance, like that. Even in the olden times also, in the Chola times, they were started in that way. But nowadays in our democratic government, we are voting, and we are the people are voting, and people only electing the so and so person is suitable as a minister, like that. Yes or no? But after electing that also, the final chief minister will give departments. Okay, but then in olden days, kings were only selecting the persons and giving their own work. Okay, giving each work like that. But at the Chola times in the Tamil Nadu, what they have did, you know? See, they have written small tickets of palm leaves. Okay, on the palm leaves, just palm leaves, small will be there, no? Then they cut it off palm leaves, and they make a small ticket. On that tickets, they have written off the work, irrigation work. Okay, or else that work, this work, like that, whatever the works are related to that fort, right? That all written in the small tickets, and that all small tickets they kept in a pot. Okay, they kept in one pot, and then call a small young boy, and one by one they call up one of the person in front of that pot, and then the boy should take out one of the palm leaves ticket. So whatever the work is came in that ticket, that person has to be do that work. For example, if some of the A person came in front of the pot, so the younger boy took out one of the ticket of the palm leaf. If it is he got it any administration work, right? So that person has to do that administration work. Okay, so these type of sabha were arranged in the Tamil Nadu in olden days. So these all information, how do we know now? These information is there in the form of inscriptions at the place of Uttar Meruru. Understood? Okay. Here, inscriptions and the text. See, I told you the person has to be selected by the kings. How the person in what cases the king will select means who want to be. For example, now we are electing some of the leaders. The leader has an experience of a political background. Okay, the leader is maybe a honesty. The leader is willing to do service to the people. These many all think of many criterion, then the people will be vote and select for the person. Yes or no? Same like that, king will elect some persons. Okay. The works, which the works only, which work should give to the which persons, that is only they will select as into a these ticket forms, like a lottery form. Yes or no? But the selecting of the persons is under control of the king. Okay. King only selecting of some persons as the Sabha members. Okay. King court is called Sabha also. Understood? So, Sabha members. That member have some of a specific qualities. What are the qualities? What are the qualities? That also, there is an information in the form of inscriptions. See, that person has land owner. That person should be have land. See, they have given here. Who could be a member of the Sabha? Yeah, I told you, right? The Uttar Merur inscription lays down. The Uttar Merur inscription given this all information. All those who wish to become member of the Sabha should be owner of land from which land revenue is collected. Okay? See, who wish to become the member of the Sabha should be owner of the land. Whoever want to be a member of that Sabha, okay? That person has to be some land, some hectares of the land he has to be owned, okay? And he has to be pay the tax for it. Tax revenue similar only, okay? So he has to be pay the tax for it. And they should be have their own houses. Yes. Okay? They should be have their own houses. And they should be have knowledge of Vedas. Okay? Sabha members should be have knowledge of Vedas. Why? Because if it is any just a case came to the Sabha, it should be solved, right? Based on the knowledge, based on the prior knowledge, based on the Puranic historic knowledge, then only the problem will be solved, right? So that's why the Sabha member should have the knowledge of Vedas. And Sabha member have to be honest. Okay? Sabha member should be honest. And every Sabha member should be well in administrative matters. Okay? Every Sabha member should be well in administrative matters. Okay? See, they should have the knowledge of Vedas. They should be well versed in administrative matters and be honest. If anyone has been a member of any committee in the last 3 years, he cannot become a member of another committee. See, if any one of the member as a committee member from last 3 years onwards, okay, if he is a member from 3 years onwards, he could not be a member in the next. Understood? Who have the experience of 3 years, that person should not be having of a Sabha member to the next periods. Okay, anyone who has not submitted his accounts, including details of his relatives, cannot contest the elections. Okay, even whatever the accounts, administrative sites or as land records, land revenues. Okay, so this type of information, if he not submit, okay, if he not submit, the person should not be allowing as a next in the elections. Understood? Elections means at that time elections, not like in that way. See, do you think women participated in these assemblies? No, at a time they did not allow the women in the assemblies or sabhas. Okay. In your view, are lotteries useful for choosing member of committees? No. See, if we choose in the form of lottery ways, maybe that person, if that person has got into the administrative side, if that person do not have any of the knowledge about it or anything, that may not be justifiable. Yes or no? So that's why it is not better of this lottery system. While inscription tell us about the kings and the powerful men, here is an expert. See, now by inscriptions, what we are getting? But we are knowing about the knowledge of whatever they written, how they arranged their sabha, how they done the elections. These are how do we know by these inscriptions? Yes or no? See like that. Here as an expert from Periyapuram. See Periyapuram. These all are Tamil words. Don't you think that any okay? It's all are Tamil words. A 12th century Tamil work which inform us about the lives of ordinary men and women. One of the inscription is there, okay, in the Tamil, and the Tamil people, how they were, ordinary people were, how they lived, men and women. On the outskirts of Adler was a small hamlet of Pulwais. Hamlet means like, we are calling like Orthanda, small areas, right? That we are calling as hamlet. See, outskirts of Adnar. Adnar means a place name. It's like a big village. See, outskirts of the Adnar, the village outside. Okay? There is one hamlet. Not hamlet, which here you are going for egg hamlet. No. Don't you think that? Hamlet. Hamlet means like a tanda. Some 10 or 12 families will live together, right? Below 10 families, like that. So, that place called as hamlet. 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 Not hamlet, O-M not, H, okay, H-A-M-L-E-T, hamlet, okay, so outskirt of the Agnur village, one hamlet is there, okay, of Pulwais. Pulwais means the peoples, okay, studded with the small huts under old thatches inhabited by agrarian laborers. Okay, that all people were using huts. Huts, you know hut? Yeah. And under the old thatches inhabited by agrarian laborers. They all are the work of labor work and engaged in minor occupations. Okay, and in the threshold of the huts covered with strips of leather, dark children who wore bracelets of black iron were prancing about carrying little puppies. In the shade of the murudu means Arjuna trees. In the shade of Arjuna trees, a female laborer put her baby to sleep on a sheet of leather. There were mango trees from whose branches drums were hanging. Under the coconut palms and little hollows on the ground, teeny headed female dogs lay after whelping. The red crushed cocks crawled before dawn, calling the brawny Pulwais plural to their day's work. And by day, under the shade of the kanji tree, spread the voice of wavy haired Pulaya women singing as they were husking paddy. See, here inscription is there, how the rural people, rural areas people, men and women, how they are living. Okay, here they gave the example about the Pulwais, in the place, Adnar place, okay, they lived in one hamlet, Pulwais people, okay, and they lived in which houses? Huts, okay. They lived in huts and they are engaging in labor works, and the women also will do the work, and if they have very small kids also, then make them to be sleep in the shades of the trees, okay, then they'll do the work. Even they only roaming off some small puppies or some of a hens and crows, okay, and all they'll continue the work, okay, and in their work, women will be some of singing their own language songs, okay, when they are cutting the paddy and all, okay. So, this is about New Kings and Kingdoms lesson, okay. All you have to read and try to understand about the Chola's kingdoms, okay, and Prastis, what is Prastis, and the land grants, okay, and about Muhammad Ghazni. And about Cholas, understood? And agriculture and irrigation systems, and about the inscriptions and the types of lands, okay? Who are giving to the Brahmanas, that is which type of land, pramadeya, like that. Okay, so that all you have to remind it and carefully have to study. Okay, and with the next lesson I'll meet you again.